In this video, we're taking a very general look at a thin ring rolling down an incline through a height of h. The ring has a mass of m and a radius of r, and we're reminded in the problem that the moment of inertia of a thin ring is given by mr squared. And of course, this ring is rolling without slipping. In part A, we want to get the translational speed at the bottom in terms of h and g. And what's going on here is an energy transfer between the gravitational potential energy of the ring, that would be mgh, if we use the bottom as the reference point, and the kinetic energy of the ring at the bottom. That consists of two components. There's the translational component, that's 1/2 m times the speed of the center of mass squared. And there's the rotational component, and that's 1/2 I omega squared. Next, we can plug in the moment of inertia for the ring. And the problem with this expression is that we have both the translational velocity, so the velocity of the center of mass, together with the rotational velocity on the right-hand side. We want to eliminate one of these in favor of the other. And what we're asked for in this problem is the translational speed. Well, the relationship between the translational speed and the rotational speed when something is rolling without slipping is given by v center of mass equals r omega. And this means omega is v center of mass over r. So we're going to make that substitution in that last term on the right-hand side. And when we square that, we get a v squared over r squared. And at this point, the r squareds cancel out. This means the translational velocity of the ring at the bottom of this incline doesn't depend on the radius of the ring. In addition, the masses cancel out, so it doesn't depend on the mass of the ring either. And what we have on the right-hand side is 1/2 v squared plus another 1/2 v squared, which gives me a total of 1 v squared. So everything simplifies here to gh on the left-hand side and v center of mass squared on the right-hand side. We quickly solve for the center of mass velocity, that's the translational velocity, and it's just the square root of gh. In part B, we're asked for the angular speed at the bottom in terms of r, h, and g, so we're just going back to this relationship, v equals r omega for an object that rolls without slipping. That means omega is v center of mass over r, and we simply plug in the answer we got from part A, that's square root gh divided by r, and we're done with that part. Finally, in part C, we're asked to compute the percentage of the kinetic energy in the rotation of the ring. And if I go back to my expression for the total kinetic energy of the rolling ring, this first term, 1/2 mv center mass squared, that's the translational kinetic energy. The second term, 1/2 I omega squared, that was the rotational kinetic energy. Well, that rotational kinetic energy term ended up simplifying to a 1/2 mv center mass squared. So in total, I have my translational kinetic energy, 1/2 mv center of mass squared, my rotational kinetic energy, which simplified by using the rolling without slipping condition, it simplified to 1/2 mv center of mass squared. And I can just tell at a glance, the translational and rotational components have exactly the same size. And this means 50% of the energy of this rolling ring is in the rotation. And that's it. If you enjoyed this video, or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.